So, in the last video, we made our gun fully automatic. You can see right now, it's quite overpowered. I can shoot for as many bullets as I want, and no one's ever gonna stop me. And in a game, that's probably a bad idea, so we need to add reloading. In order to do that, we're going to go to our gun and open up the server and client scripts to start off with. Now, you might think it'd be easier to go into the client script and do a check, like if the ammo left is less than zero, then you reload the gun. But that's a bad idea because you should never, ever trust the client. And that's a big thing in Roblox in any server client application, like ever, because the client could inject malicious code to maybe bypass the reload system so they can shoot as much as they want. And you do not want that to happen. That's a bad idea. So we're going to do all of our reloading on the server script. So we're going to start off down here and create a variable local ammo left and set this equal to 30. Now, really, in a real like production game, you'd want to define this as a constant, but for our case, just for simplicity, we're going to leave it as a literal value. And then now we can say local reloading equals false. This will be a boolean just telling us when our gun is reloading. And now we can define our reload function. And all this will do is just reload the gun. But you could just say, like, wait 10 seconds and then set ammo left equal to 30 again. The problem with this is if reload gets called multiple times within an event, it'll keep on reloading the gun repeatedly, which is not what you want. So we have to add a few checks here. First of which is by saying if reloading, then return end. So if we've already been reloading and this function has been called, we only want to reload one time at like one specific point in time. So that's why we put that there. And then we can set reloading to true. So this is a basic debounce. If you don't know what debouncing is, I have a video on it and I will link it right now. And then we can wait reload time. So I'm just going to do like 10 seconds is fine. Maybe 5 seconds just for quick. It'll only be able to be called once, and then we can reset our ammo. So this does nothing on its own. We obviously need to implement that. And to do that, we're going to go to the fire function, because this is what's called by our fire event. So in here, we're going to say if ammo left is greater than zero and not reloading, then. And then we're going to indent this whole block here, put an else, and here's our little logic. And then we're going to say reload. So what's going to happen is when we call the fire event, it's going to check if we have enough ammo and check if we're not reloading. And this might seem redundant, but it'll come into play a little bit later, this little line right here. And then if we don't have enough ammo, we will reload the gun. And we can do this even if we start clicking while we're reloading, because it'll keep on calling the reload function, but the reload function knows that it can only be called once, and that's why we have that little debounce up there. Now, this won't work as is because the ammo left never gets depleted, so right below our caster fire, we're going to say ammo left minus equals 1. So this will subtract 1 from ammo left every time we shoot the gun, which is exactly what we want. So with no client code changed, this should work as is. So if we have our gun, shoot it, and you can see it stops. I'm spam clicking. I'm clicking as much as I can, and nothing's happening. And then I got to shoot again. The fire rate is like really, really high. So yeah, and there you go. I killed the zombie, which is exactly what we want. But I can't spam it as much as I want, which is really good. So the basic reload functionality is done, but what if the player wants to reload before they run out of ammo? We haven't really addressed that, so let's go into our client script and let's start. So first thing we want to do is reference the context action service. And this will be equal to game get service context action service. And then also what we want to do is go into the gun, click the plus, and create another remote event, and I'm going to name this the reload event. And this will be responsible for notifying the server when the client wants to reload their gun. And let's reference it here by saying local reload event equals tool wait for child reload event. Now down here, what we want to do is instead of just instantly saying context action service bind action, actually, I misspelled it. There we go. We need to say tool dot equipped connect function. And then we also need to make a tool dot unequipped and just connect a function. And the reason we need to do this is when we equip our tool, we want to bind the reload action. And then when we unequip it, we want to unbind it. And we'll just set that up right now by saying context action service bind action. And so this takes a few parameters. The first is a name, which we'll set to reload. The next is a function, which we'll just set to a function. And then over here, we're also going to say comma after the functions. And we're going to say false, and then enum.keycode.r. So what this does is we have our name, we have the function we want to run when all of these key codes are pressed. So right now when we hit r, it'll reload. This false is telling this function that we do not want a mobile button. Obviously, if you're dealing with a mobile game with mobile controls, you would want to do that. But for the example, we don't really need it. So this function that will be called when we press R takes in three parameters, the name, which will always be reload, the state, and the input object. All we really need is a state, and we can just say if state equals enum.userInputState.begin, then we want to fire our reload event by saying reload event fire. So what this does is we check the state, so like begin is when the key is down, because this function runs when it begins and when it ends. We don't want the reload to fire twice, that's just redundant, so we'll only fire it once when the key is clicked. And then down here in our tool to unequipped, we'll say context action service unbind action reload. So when our tool is equipped, we bind our action, and then when your tool is unequipped, we unbind it. And in this example, it doesn't really do anything, but when you have multiple guns with multiple reloads and a bunch of binded actions, you'll definitely want to do this. And it's just a good practice, because you shouldn't have a bound action that you're not going to be using. And when the tool is unequipped, you should not bind it. So let's run this, and we can just check it out. So if I shoot a little bit, and I click R, oh, there's an error. It's actually fire server. I did that wrong. And honestly, when we test this, now that I think about it, it won't do anything since we have nothing on the server. But the server setup is quite easy. Let me go to the top where we defined our other event. Let me just find it real quick. Underneath our fire event, we'll say local reload event equals tool.reloadEvent. And then all the way at the bottom where we have our tool.equipped and fire event, we can just say reload event dot on server event connect reload. So whenever we click R, it'll just call the reload function on the server, which is what we want to do, because that'll just reset the ammo and prevent us from shooting. So if we shoot a little bit and then click R, and then try shooting, doesn't work. After a while, we'll get it back, and we can shoot the zombies to our heart's content. And this doesn't really have to do with our reload, but one thing we want to add, and I forgot to add this in the other two videos, is a simple line in our fire function, where we say, if tool dot parent is a backpack, then return end. So what this line does is it basically prevents our gun from firing while it's unequipped, which is honestly a pretty big oversight on my part, my bad, but you just add this line so when your tool is unequipped, it will not shoot. Because the client local script will still run whether it's equipped or unequipped, because this run service.stepped is always running. But that's about it for this video. So I hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure to like and subscribe if you did. Comment any questions or suggestions down below and tell me what you want to see next in this series. But other than that, I hope you have a nice day and goodbye.